Let's go back to the phone lines. Let's talk next to Brent. He's listening in Kansas City, Missouri. Hi, Brent.
Hey, man. This kind of goes in line with what you're talking about with the Word of Faith movement. Listening to Bob Larson years ago, I know he's kind of nutty. He had his scam or whatever where people would say they're demon-possessed and he would free them and all that. But he made a statement, I've heard others make a statement, that a Christian can be demon-possessed, which seems to kind of be ironic that the Word of Faithers would say that you automatically have godlike properties because you are a believer now. You can't get sick. You know, you have all these things. So I just kind of want to know what's your take on what the Bible says about demon possession of Christians is, and people like Bob Larson, do you think that those situations are actually legit? Are they common?
Well, they're not legit, and unfortunately, I was just reading in the newspaper how many Catholics are being taught exorcism rules and so often apply those exorcism rules to believers. So it's a pretty big problem on a wide scale within biblical Christianity. People are misunderstanding the Word of God. As far as the Word of Faith teachers are concerned, remember this, they believe that your words access the force, either the force of fear or the force of faith. If you access the force of faith, then you'll have unlimited wealth and unlimited health. If you access the force of fear, then you give Satan the right to enter and to destroy your life in many different ways. That's the particular story that they tell. But the point from Scripture could not be clearer. Christians cannot be demon-possessed. And there's a very significant argument given in this regard by Jesus Christ himself. He asked the question, how can anyone enter a strong man's house and carry off his possessions unless he first ties up the strong man? Well, in the case of a demon-possessed person, the strong man is the devil. In a spirit-possessed person, the strong man is God. And the force of the argument that Christ is making here leads to the conclusion that in order for demons to possess believers, they would first have to bind the one who occupies them. In other words, they would first have to bind God. Perish the thought. The point is simply this. If your temple is the temple of the Holy Spirit, your temple being your body, if that is the temple of the Holy Spirit, then that temple will never be inhabited by a demon. Therefore, you will never be possessed of God because you are in relation to the Holy Spirit. And greater is the one that is in you than the one that is in the world. So there's no possibility whatsoever that Christians can be demon-possessed. And so when you have people like Bob Larson doing his carnival act and seeing demons come out of Christians, some looking like the Pillsbury Doughboy, you know that you have just entered into cultic thinking. And again, unless you know the truth, it is so easy to fall for the skin of the truth, stuffed with a great big lie. We'll be right back with your questions right here on the Bible Answer Man broadcast. Resources in this regard at equip.org.